Namaste. Thank you for clicking on this video. We will continue our exploration of Jagannath for us of where that is given to the astrological world free by Sri P.V.R. Narasimha Rao ji. I will take his name in every video because the thing that he have done must be appreciated. Right? Let's continue with further settings of Jagannath Hora and what I use. Right. This video is specifically for my own students. Why I am uploading it live on YouTube? Because I think that many people follow my teachings and my techniques as I tell on YouTube. So it is for all of you. If you don't agree to my settings, just ignore the video. Right. Or you can listen to it to increase your knowledge and can continue with your settings. Right. As I told in my earlier video as well, if you use my techniques of prediction, it is better to use the settings that I use. Otherwise, listen to the video, enhance your knowledge. If you are convinced, use it. If you are not convinced, you can fairly leave it. That's not an issue. Right? So let's start with Jyotira and the further settings, right? Preferences related to calculations. We have seen up to Siddhanta planetary model, Trik Siddhanta versus Sri Surya Siddhanta and Ayanamsha. I'll explore other settings. The first is planet calculation options. The first thing is geocentric position versus topocentric position. So I am born in Delhi and you are born at some other place, right? For the whole of the world, the planetary calculations, the planetary positions are calculated from Greenwich in England. So when the planetary positions for any horoscope is calculated from the center of Earth taken as Greenwich, it is known as geocentric position, globe centric. But this is not the approach. Why? Because as I have told earlier also, sages opine that given the calculation in a Siddhanta text versus the observation of the sky done by the astrologer, at any given point of time, the observation of the sky as done by the astrologer should be given preference. Now, in earlier times, there was an astrologer for a particular area. So suppose you are born in Delhi, you will go to your nearest astrologer. Your parents will go to your nearest astrologer and will tell him to make a horoscope. He will observe the planetary positions from Delhi and write it in the horoscope. That is the way told by sages. If you know about the calculation of the ascendant, you will know that the place which comes in east decides the ascendant. I will give you a pictorial example. Yep. Take this as sky. And take this as Earth. Take this as East. This as West. This as South. And this as North. And suppose it is Rashis. It is Aries up to this extent. It is Taurus up to this extent. It is Gemini up to this extent. It is Cancer up to this extent. Suppose child A is born here and child B is born here. So I will draw a hypothetical line from this point in the eastern direction. I come to at one point of Taurus. Here will be 0 degree. Here will be 30 degree and approximately the child will be born somewhere around, say, 24 degrees. So for this child A, the ascendant will be Taurus, 24 degrees. Whereas for this child B, when I calculate a direct line, this is 0 degree, this is 30 degree of Gemini, and the child will be born somewhere near around 9 degrees. So for this child B, the birth will be Gemini 9 degree. This is the calculation of an ascendant. Now the planetary positions are being calculated from this place, Greenwich. Now you think yourself how much suitable it is to calculate ascendant from this point and a planetary position from this point. Let me tell you something. In horoscope, there are different houses: first house, second house, third house, fourth house, fifth house, sixth house, seventh house, eighth house, ninth house, and 12th house. There are 12 houses in horoscope, right? Now, all the houses are decided based on the ascendant. Only the ascendant is calculated. And once you find that the person, that the child is Taurus ascendant, then automatically the second house will be Gemini, third house will be Cancer, fourth house will be Leo, fifth house will be Virgo, sixth house will be Libra, seventh house will be Scorpio, eighth house will be Sagittarius, ninth house will be Capricorn, 10th house will be Aquarius, 11th house will be Pisces, and the 12th house will be Aries automatically. So the calculation of ascendant decides the 12 houses and the Rashis that will fall in the 12 houses. Now it is bitter natural that we should also calculate the planetary positions from that place where the child is born, instead of calculating it from the Greenwich, right? Because in earlier times, in the calculations mentioned by sages, there is no provision of a center of Earth. Right? The planets are always calculated based on the place where the person is born. For this particular reason, while calculating, we will use the topocentric position, which is planets calculated for the place where the person is born, and not geocentric position, which is planets calculated from the center of the Earth. If you have seen my Hindi video on Geohora, I have recommended geocentric positions there, but that should not be followed. Use topocentric positions only, right? This is a new update that I am giving you. Of course, even at that time for that video, I told geocentric positions, but in reality, I used topocentric positions only. And all those students who have been enrolled with me at that point of time know the fact that I used topocentric positions only, but for the sake of that, leaving it aside. Planets' true positions should be used. Don't use refraction, annual abbreviation of light, gravitational deflection, use nutation, everything is fine. Now coming to nodes, there are two calculations, mean nodes and true nodes. What should be used? Now, what is mean and what is true? That needs to be understood. If you have watched the first video, you must remember that I told you that there is a Karma Grantha. There is a Siddhanta. Suppose Aryabhatta wrote a book in 2009 and wrote that at this point of time, right now in 2009, Saturn is at 20 degree Gemini. And according to my observation of the last 30 years, I have seen that Saturn moves at this speed. And after this much time becomes retrograde at this and this speed, and then becomes direct and then travel at this speed. The calculation is given for 2019. If I just use the formula and find the position of Saturn for now and write it in the horoscope, it will be told as the mean position of Saturn, approximate position of Saturn. Whereas if I go to the sky, if I watch the sky, watch the current position of Saturn and write it in the horoscope, it will be known as true position of Saturn. It will be known as the true position of Saturn. In earlier times, mean position of almost every planet was considered. True positions of planets were considered only by those astrologers who had access to telescopes or who knew how to see planets in the sky and write them in a horoscope. Over the time, the technology improved, and now we have the power to write true positions of every planet. And then why the problem with Rahu and Ketu? The thing is that Rahu and Ketu are two points of the sky. The maximum degree moon can travel in north is Rahu, and the maximum degree moon can travel in the south is Ketu. So when the moon is with Rahu, he is at the northernmost position. When the moon is with Ketu, he is at the southernmost position of the zodiac, of course. Right. So these are the Rahu and Ketu. And Rahu and Ketu, you cannot see them in sky. And their calculation, because they are not planets, their calculation is a bit complex. So in earlier times, despite the fact that we had technology to see the true position of planets, astrologers rarely bother to see the true positions of Rahu and Ketu, to write it in natal horoscopes. But in the case of eclipse, because in Indian astrology, there is a tradition of writing when the eclipse will start, when the eclipse will end, what will be the peak time of eclipse. Since time immemorial, for the case of eclipse, only true positions of Rahu and Ketu were considered. Because if you don't take true positions of Rahu and Ketu, then the eclipse that will happen in reality and the eclipse that will be written in the Panchanga will differ. So since time immemorial, for the calculation of eclipse, only the true position of Rahu and Ketu were used. But for the case of writing it in the natal horoscopes, because the calculation of Rahu and Ketu was difficult, mean positions were used. But now, because we have the power of technology, information, and software, why should we do injustice to Rahu and Ketu? So write true positions of Rahu and Ketu. When you write the true positions of Rahu and Ketu, sometimes Rahu and Ketu can be direct as well. Sometimes Rahu and Ketu can be stationary as well. Many people opine that using mean nodes give them better result in predictions. However, I think they haven't explored the true possibility of using Rahu and Ketu. I will give you one small technique to check the efficiency. What I have found is that if someone is having a stationary Rahu, if any planet becomes retrograde and direct both, then that planet will be stationary also. Because when the planet changes its motion, when the planet changes its motion from direct to retrograde, or when the planet changes its motion from retrograde to direct, or sometime it remains still in the sky, it remains freezed at a position in the sky for some time, this is known as stationary position. I have personally found that all those women and men who have stationary Rahu, married those people who have already been married. I remember, I was having chat on an astrological forum. I remember looking at the chart of a lady who got married to a person who was already married to, like who was divorced. Right. So the lady was, it was the lady's first marriage. But the male, the groom, was divorced. And I concluded after looking at that chart that it is because of Rahu being stationary. After 3-4 years of that incident, I was doing a chart. And the lady also had a stationary Rahu. And the lady was asking for whether she will be able to marry her boyfriend or not. She was an Indian lady, like, you know, Indian lady, North Indian. North India born, North India living. And she asked that whether she will be able to marry the guy she's in love with. I saw stationary Rahu and I predicted that, and I asked her that your boyfriend is already married to someone or is he divorced? And she accepted the fact that yes, my boyfriend is divorced. And I want to get married to him. And of course, we got married to her as well, right? The trade-off is stationary Rahu. So this is a small technique. This is a small research that I have found. I thought to share it with you. So search over it. Give me some feedback. There are many more uses of stationary Rahu as well. Now, how to see if a planet is stationary using Jagannath Hora software is what I want to show you here. This lady, you right click on this screen, enter screen. You choose latitudes, speeds, etc. coordinates. You can see in this chart, the longitudinal speed of Rahu is 0.028 degree per day. Right. Latitudinal speed is 0.00 degree per day. We are concerned with longitudinal speed. Longitudinal speed is 0.028 degree per day. It is about to become stationary. And it is direct also. Any planet that is retrograde, his longitudinal speed will be written in minus. For an example, in some times from now, Saturn is going to be retrograde. So you can see in this chart that Saturn and Jupiter are retrograde, and it is written minus 0.134 for Jupiter and minus 0.069 for Saturn. So any planet whose retrograde, its degrees will be written in minus. Because in this chart, there is no minus before Rahu. This Rahu is direct. And because the speed is 0.028 degree, this Rahu is about to become stationary, although not completely stationary. This is how you check any stationary planet. For an example, in this particular horoscope, Jupiter is a stationary. When you look at the longitudinal speed of Jupiter, it is 0.007 degree per day. So longitudinal speed is about to become zero. When the longitudinal speed will be completely zero, the planet will be completely stationary. The planet is slowing down, Jupiter is slowing down. So this is how you find a planet who is stationary or going to be stationary in Jagannath Hora. Using this same thing also, you can also find when a planet is on its normal speed, when a planet is faster in its speed, when the planet is slower in its speed, etc., etc., etc. How to find it and what are the implications of fast planet, slow planet, retrograde planet, stationary planet. I have covered it completely in the first class of my Art of Prashna. So you can purchase that thing as well. My point here is to show you how do we know the stationary position of planet and emphasize that we should use the true positions of Rahu. That is very useful. There are many predictions that can be made just based on the fact that Rahu is stationary or Rahu is direct. I make at least 10-15 predictions just based on these two factors, that Rahu is direct or stationary. It is quite a useful technique. So just to explain that I use two positions for Rahu and Ketu, because the true position of every planet should be used, as true is more precise, better. Because we have the power of software and technology, the true position of every planet, including Rahu and Ketu, should be used. Going further to the next setting, after leaving it here, the next setting is Upagraha calculation option. Dhuma Gatipata relation. In Brihat Parashar and in other texts, Brihat Parashar, Jatak Parijat, where the calculation of Dhuma is told. Where the calculation of Dhuma and Vithipat is told. It is told that Vithipat is one Rashi minus the position of Dhuma. Sorry. It is told that 12 Rashi minus the position of Dhuma is Vithipat. The same formula is given. Vithipat is equal to 360 degree minus Dhuma. 12 Rashi is 360 degree. 1 Rashi is 30 degree. 30 divided by 12 is equal to 360. So the calculation of Vithipat is equal to 360 degree minus Dhuma should be used. Right. Regarding the calculation of Gulika and Mandi, some texts like Sarvachandamani, etc. consider Gulika and Mandi as separate entities. However, 98% of the traditional astrologers, and according to what I have learned in the Kerala stream of astrology, is that Gulika and Mandi is the same plan. Even those who take Gulika and Mandi as separate, they will accept the fact that Gulika is a time factor which is only to be used in rectification of horoscope. Whereas Mandi is treated like a planet used for prediction. I will repeat it once again. Either you take Gulika and Mandi as the same planet, that is okay. In that scenario, you only use it for prediction, not for rectification. Right? Generally, in my Kerala studies, what I have learned in Kerala, what I have learned in tradition, I have learned that Gulika should be used to rectify birth horoscope. And there are many shlokas given on that. Right? And Mandi should be used for calculation. However, the calculation of Gulika or Mandi, anything given here in the software Jagannath Hora is not right, is incorrect according to my understanding of the calculation of Gulika and Mandi. So what is the real calculation? This can be your question, right? So I have written an article. That article is available on my website www.shivamalav.com. And that article deals with the calculation of Gulika and Mandi. That article deals with the correct calculation of Mandi. You should open my website www.shivamalav.com. Search for this article, Ashtamangala Roga Prashna. That is an article I wrote on April 23rd, 2020. That's 1 year now. And in this article, I have given the calculation of Gulika and Mandi. Oh, sorry, Gulika only. I'm doing this mistake again and again. Pardon me for that. The calculation is given here. Mandi rise time is equal to sunrise time plus day span or night span. Day span is the duration from sunrise to sunset. Night span is the duration from sunset to the next sunrise divided by 15 multiplied by Muhurta count for the day. Right? Muhurta count for the day and night are separate that I have given here. Right? And the ascendant calculated for the above calculated time is the Mandi longitude for the day. The complete formula is given in my article, Astamangal Ro Prashna, here, and the article is available on my website. There is only one software, as far as I know, which gives you the correct calculation of Mandi. That is a mobile software that only works on Android. It is named as Astroride. The software was earlier available in Malayalam only. Now it is available in English as well. So either you can use this formula that is written on my website, and this is the formula that I use. for predictive purpose, specifically in Prashna, the method given in Jagannath Hora is erroneous, is not right. But still, for the sake of uses, I take the calculation of Gulika rises at the beginning of Saturn's portion and Mandi rises at the end of Saturn's portion. And what I actually do is what I'll tell you. In the chart, I will take the position of Mandi. And I will take the, I will take the position of Gulika first and I will take the position of Mandi. And I will find the span and the middle portion of it. Like the complete span, specifically the middle portion of it, I will take as the thing that is affected by Gulika and Mandi. Because the correct calculation cannot be done. Just for the sake of using it in the software. Otherwise, what I will do is I will use the formula that I have given in my article. So I will take it as from 16 degree of Aquarius up to 14 degree of Pisces, the complete part is afflicted by Gulika and Mandi. The calculation that I use is Gulika rises at the beginning of Saturn's portion and Mandi rises at the end of Saturn's portion. Because there is the correct option is not in the Jagannath Hora software. Whereas for all other Upagrahas, Kala, Mrityu, Ardhaprahar, Yamakantak, and for other four Upagrahas, Kala, Mrityu, Yamakantak, and Ardhaprahar, they rise at the beginning of respective portions of Kala is Upagraha of Sun, Mrityu is Upagraha of Mars, Ardhaprahar is the Upagraha of Mercury, and Yamakantak is the Upagraha of Jupiter. They rise at the respective portions of Sun, Mars, etc. etc. What is the respective portion? This is the rise portion of their Muhurta. Suppose 9 a.m. today is the time when the Muhurta of Jupiter will start. So the ascendant that will be there at 9 a.m. will be the place where the non-luminary of Jupiter named Yamakantak will be placed. That is a technical calculation. What I use is Kala, Mrityu, etc. rises at the beginning of respective poses. For day and night start at the sunrise and sunset respectively is the calculation that I use. Right. Sun starts the day.